As this pass intercepted by Fobar, he drops it down low, fires a shot, and scores.
Had a good handful of Chavez up front. Oh. Epperly scores on the pass from back behind the net, and he's swimming on the ice. Blazer as it came from behind the net. Bells can't clear. Voiles, though, gets flattened by Fobar. Corona-Norco only four times.
Watch out. Shane Weller walking in, still walking in. Waits, fires a shot, and there's making a save is Blazer.
Beat 3-on-1 for the Coyotes. Wolivar back door, he scores! Sound played games I've seen in a while. Reed out front, shot. Oh, and it was blocked by Boynton. One away here with 3 seconds to go. Couldn't get the pass away. He's undercut and goes down hard. Away by Evan Pace. Evan Pace got some speed, too. He's going to lift it. Oh, he scores! Oh, wow. You're going to pick it up far side. Christian Papadopoulos is right behind him, though. Oh, and a big hit. Lloyd trying to tee up Nabuja. Stick, but he's still going to get there in time. A little bit of space. His shot and a glove save by Vernon.
Oh, reach it, enters the zone. Tried to chip it over to... The shot and score! Toby Costa somehow banked it off the goaltender.
And overall...
Ooh, big save right there.
Up
shot goal.
Oh, there it is, Stavich, finally. That is killed off 26 of 30 penalties. Shorthanded, here they come. Budisov, he scores! Epperly. Gontusi scores!
That's a Hattie.
In the middle, here's a shot, and that one hit Gustlin in the skin. Went by the goaltender, Mack. Hard to get possession, finally grabs it in the middle. He's got Nelson who shoots, what a save, rebound! Markman had a pass, here they come again. Kramer shot, rebound! Save by Mack.
Oh!
Came out front, Montanez put it off the post.
Missed that.
On a rebound, the puck is still loose out in front of the net. Where did it go? Near side.
There it is.
Risto roofs and he scores!
Good job by Risto. He's won by Semkew. He will now bring the puck in. Bidding for goal number 3. Shot, score!
Wolivar ahead to Reed. Reed on the brakes in the middle. Back door, shot, score! And Christie going the length of the ice between everybody to a backhand. A kick save by Vernon as he sprawled out of the left leg. Comes Grant Marhoff back the other way. Oh, and he is just, he moves ahead. A 1-on-2. Oh, by himself. Put it on the blade. Toe of his stick there. Try to backhand her, but he missed the net. Centering pass, tipped in! Jeremy Mills! Magic here, turns on the jets, slams on the brakes, shot and a kick save! 3 seconds gone by and the penalty. Bolivar skating through everybody, trying to lift it in. Go. A backhand try, and this one's gonna go in for Aguirre on a second try. And for six to go up in celebration. Everton, a shot short-handed, rebound!
Save.
What a save by AJ Frosch, diving to his left.
This is the Anaheim Ducks High School Hockey League report on ADHSHL.com and Black Dog Enterprises. How's it going, everybody? Andy Dickerson here with Black Dog Enterprises. Had a massive Week 16 report to go over. A record-setting 10 games on the slate. Starting off on Friday with Corona-Norco and Los Alamitos, Andre Gontus led the way with a hat trick and an assist. It'll be the start of a big weekend for him. Mitchell Hodges pitched in 2 goals as well for the Griffins. Jacob Stavich and Eric Anderson, a goal and assist each in the losing effort for the Stingrays as they fell 9-4 to the Griffins. SportsnetUSA.net's Emily Harlan sat down with Los Alamitos' head coach, Sandy Gasseau, after the win.
Coach, with this win, you remain undefeated, winning 11 straight games. What has been the key to your success this season?
I think depth. We have a lot of depth, so, you know, we've been missing some players here and there, but it seems like when we're missing players, other players step up, so it's a chance for them. Like tonight, we had 4 lines, so maybe a little less ice time for everybody, but most of the time, we kind of have, like, 3 lines, so I think it's our depth, so it's good.
And tomorrow you have quite the matchup facing the other undefeated team in your division. How are you going to beat Capistrano United and keep this win streak going?
It's going to be tough. I mean, we haven't seen them, but just by the scores, they seem to be very good offensively. So we'll have to be better defensively than we were tonight to have a chance.
Second game on Friday night, Varsity 1A matchup between the Bellarmine Bells and the Orange Lutheran Lancers. Bellarmine's first of 4 games. On the weekend, it was all Lancers early on as they led 4-1 by the end of the early second period, with Brody Norcutt scoring 2 goals, 1 assist. Riley Kramer, 2 goals as well. The Bells made a big comeback with Gabe Silva scoring two goals, Evan Pace two as well, including the game-tying goal with less than 2 minutes left.
Stopped. Frosch.
Oh, right, it's goal!
Frosch complaining that he had it.
In overtime, Brody Norcutt took the game into his hands.
Boy, he's got Dietz right behind him. Brody with a shot. It scores! Oh, he somehow beat Mack and the Lancers! Pick up a second point of the standings. Chuck, the Lancers have moved into second place in Varsity 1A.
Here's Emily with Orange Lutheran's assistant coach, Dan Adams.
Coach, another close game with Bellarmine, and you face them again in less than 24 hours. What are you going to focus on tomorrow to ensure another victory?
Tomorrow we have to work a lot on our defensive zone coverage. We had a lot of problems down in front of our net. Our goalie today, AJ Frosch, played exceptional. Stood on his head, as we say, and just had a phenomenal game. Really bailed out our defensemen today. So.
And Brody Norcutt opened the scoring for your team with an impressive goal in the first period. Netted the game winner in overtime and also leads your team in points. How exciting is it for you to have a player like that on your team?
Oh, it's great. He's a great player, phenomenal hands. Good team player out there, plays on a line with Riley Kramer, who I don't know how many points he has this year, but he's just awesome to watch. The two of them playing together, and whoever we throw them with, you know, makes them look better. But both those guys, I wouldn't have one of them without the other, for sure.
Fast forward to Saturday, as Bellarmine got up early and took on Servite. JSerra San Ramon was under siege in this game, the goaltender for Servite, as it was a 10-1 final in favor of the visiting Bellarmine Bells. Two hat tricks in the game for the Bells, Lucas Simcue and Jared Southwell recording those. Here's Emily with Bellarmine assistant coach Ken Mack.
Mack, Coach Jared Southwell scored two goals 46 seconds apart in the first period. Did that set the tone for the rest of the game?
Absolutely, absolutely. He's a real spark plug for our team. He brings a lot of energy, and it's a lot of fun to have around the locker room, and your kids really rally around him, so we're really happy for him to get those two goals.
And I'm always impressed by your team making the drive down from San Jose and playing multiple games throughout the weekend. How do you prepare your players during practice to make sure they're ready to come and play back-to-back games?
Well, a lot of it is conditioning, but basically we treat these games like a tournament, right? You know, a lot of these guys come from a travel hockey background. We'll go and we'll play three or four games over the course of a weekend. So a lot of these guys are kind of used to that kind of a schedule. It is more difficult for us with the road schedule, it is a challenge. I have to say that. But at the end of the day, our guys are young. They can do it.
Four radio-only games during the weekend, the first of which, Villa Park, taking a 5-1 win over the Edison Chargers. Five different goal scorers for the Spartans, and 4 2-10s issued between the two teams with a scrum at the end of that game. Corona-Norco took on San Diego South, and while the Stingrays amassed an early lead held into the third period, Cameron Rorick scored two goals, and the Redhawks picked up the comeback victory 5-4. Meanwhile, over at Westminster Ice, Huntington Beach took on a shorthanded Long Beach prep squad, as Long Beach only had 9 skaters in the game. They led late into the game, though, until Huntington Beach tied it up. Two goals from Cole Rettle, and then Jordan Bonner scored the OT game winner with only 16 seconds left in the extra period. Finally, late on Saturday night, Corona Del Mar took on Damien. 3 third period goals for Corona Del Mar gave them the victory, including 2 goals from Paul Selleck. There were 2 more games on Saturday with full video and audio, including the Varsity 2A Game of the Week between Capistrano United and Los Alamitos. This one certainly lived up to the billing, as it was back and forth throughout, 4-2 after the first period. The teams traded scores, led by Capistrano United's Paul and Michael Batusoff. 3 goals for Michael, 2 goals and 2 assists for Paul. Turning point in the game in the first period, as Capistrano United pulled the goaltender with 10 seconds left, looking for an extra score.
Oh, it's taken away. He's got to shoot the puck. And it goes in. Did it beat the buzzer? It did. Christie scores. And Darren Gardner's strategy backfires here.
And that unexpected empty net goal at the end of the first period brought Los Alamitos back within 1, and that would come into play later as Andre Gontus picked up his fifth goal of the game to tie it up late in the third period. And then in the overtime frame, while on the power play, the Coyotes covered the puck in the crease, which merited a penalty shot by a player of their choice, and who else did the Griffins choose but Andre Gontus.
Right at center ice, he'll move to his right a little bit and then come right down the middle, and he'll go to a back header, he scores! And the Los Alamitos Griffins win it in overtime! 8-7, the final score, Gontus' sixth goal of the game, and the Griffins are 12-0.
Here's Emily once more.
Coach, we knew this was going to be a good game. We knew it was going to be a close game. What was the key to beating the Coyotes tonight?
I think just what we talked about, you know, fighting back. I mean, we fell behind, which we don't really usually. And, you know, our plays just, you know, our players didn't stop. They kept coming, and we kept closing the gap. Every time they got a lead, we came back. So I think we just kept fighting.
And I can't say enough good things about Andre Gontus, who had 3 goals yesterday, 6 goals tonight, including the game winner by a penalty shot in overtime. How exciting is it for you to have a player like that in your lineup?
Yeah, no, Andre's a great kid, and, you know, he's, it's funny, I was talking to his dad before the game, and I said, he's got to step it up, like, you know, I'm always putting pressure on my players, and he did. He stepped up, and, you know, he was a big reason why we made the comeback, that's for sure.
Orange Lutheran and Bellarmine took on each other once more on Saturday night. This one was physical, as the two teams not take a liking to each other in the second go-round. Riley Kramer and Brody Norcutt again led the offense for the Lancers. 2 goals for Kramer, a goal and 2 assists for Norcutt. Bellarmine got a goal and an assist from Matt Everton, but it wasn't quite enough as they fell 3-2 to the Lancers. After the game, Emily sat down with Bellarmine team captain Gabe Silva.
Gabe, you lost Orange Lutheran in overtime last night. Did the game strategy change at all in facing the Lancers again today?
It did, actually. Before the game today, we went over some points in the hotel, and I thought we executed them pretty well, and I think we'll keep working on them for next time.
And you lead your team in goals and points. What do you think is the main reason for your success this season?
It's with the help of all my other teammates. They're helping me, setting me up, giving me passes, and it's a team effort, and that's what's leading me all the goals and points.
Finally, everybody got up really early on Sunday morning, 8:15 a.m. start time for the Bells versus the JSerra Lions. After the Lions scored early to take a 1-0 lead, it was all Bells as Connor Downing, Evan Pace, and Lucas Simcue scored to give the Bells a 3-1 victory. Jake Blazier made 23 saves to get the win, and the Bells went home with a 2-1-1 record on the weekend. Emily with Bellarmine head coach Ray Kellam.
Coach, you played JSerra twice before this game and lost both of those matchups. What was the difference this time around?
We decided to implement a much more defensive system. JSerra is really good at capitalizing on turnovers, 2-on-1s, breakaways, so our whole game plan was to negate that, and it worked out nicely.
And after the second period, you were tied at 1 apiece, and then Evan Pace came out and scored early on in the third. What did you say to your team in that second intermission to get them to come out and battle the way that they did?
They're not giving me enough. There's a whole lot more in the tank that they can do, and I wasn't satisfied with the energy, the effort. Even though they were working hard, I kind of tricked them because I know that they could give more. And it's a long bus ride home, so no need to use all that energy sitting on your butt.
Taking a look at the updated standings, Santa Margarita idle this weekend, still atop the standings. Orange Lutheran picked up the 2 victories to pull a little closer. JSerra and Bellarmine only separated by 1 point, though the Lions do have 3 games in hand. Los Alamitos remains at 12-0 atop the standings. Capistrano United also separating from the pack. Huntington Beach, Damien, and Long Beach Prep round out the top 5 as teams start to seed themselves for the playoffs later in February. Next week, Los Alamitos will take on Corona Del Mar on Friday. That's radio only on SportsnetUSA.net. Then on Saturday, a couple more radio-only games in the morning. Long Beach Prep versus Corona-Norco at 11:45 a.m. Corona Del Mar and San Diego South at 1:30 p.m. followed by Capistrano United and Damien, as the Coyotes will look to bounce back from that OT loss to the Griffins. Our video coverage starts with Huntington Beach versus Villa Park at 5 p.m. And our only Varsity 1A game of the weekend, Santa Margarita, will take on the Servite Friars at 6:45 p.m. This has been the Anaheim Ducks High School Hockey League Report on ADHSHL.com and Black Dog Enterprises. Thanks for watching.